Today we're out patterning our shotgun. We're shooting a Benelli Super Black Eagle 3. We're going to test a mid-range and a long-range Carlson's choke tube, and we're going to test Ken ammunition. And we're also going to use Birchwood Casey Matrix target that's 30 inches in diameter. A couple other things that are real important when you're pattern testing is you need a good rest and you need a good bench. Both have to be solid like these are, and that way every time you pull the trigger, you know you're spot on, so you're not pulling shots. A few really important safety tips while we're out here patterning that you should remember is, number one, always have a good pair of safety glasses to protect your eyes when you're shooting. You also want to use some good hearing protection. I even use it when I'm hunting, but it's very important when you're shooting off a bench or really any time you're shooting a shotgun. And then lastly, the most important thing is always make sure this gun is unloaded and on safe when you're going back and forth down to check your target. Lock the bolt back, make sure the safety's on. Today we're shooting a Super Black Eagle 3 12 gauge. It's got a 3.5 inch chamber. These are 12 gauge bismuth loads we're gonna shoot today, but most importantly, when you're out patterning, make sure you've got the right shot shells to go with the gun that you're pattern testing. So before you get out here to pattern test your shotgun, you should make sure it fits you. Nowadays, a lot of shotguns come with shim kits so you can make them fit left or right on your cant. This is the Benelli Super Black Eagle 3. And it's got that capability of fitting you. The other option is a lot of these guns come with different thicknesses of recoil pads, so you can either get a thin or thicker one to match your length of pull. Getting the gun to fit you properly is very important before you come out here and pattern test. So now we're back at the bench and we're going to shoot. And one of the most critical things about patterning your shotgun, or hunting for that matter, is sight picture. So you want to take the same sight picture here at the bench that you're going to take when you're out hunting. And I'm going to overlay the mid-rib sight onto the front sight, and I'm going to float or see the target, in this case the bullseye that I'm shooting at. So we just got done shooting and we're here with our target, and you can see the center mass of that pattern. And that's just exactly what I want out of that mid-range tube at the 20 yards we're shooting at. Now this would be a good time if you want the pattern either tighter or more open, that you would try a different choke. I'm happy with this, so now what I want to do is I want to move out back to 40 yards. I want to use the mid-range choke and the long-range choke and compare the two patterns at 40 yards and see which choke I would choose at that distance. Now we're down at our target that we just shot at 40 yards at the mid-range choke. And this is the importance of these big targets. This target is more than 30 inches by 30 inches, but more importantly, it captures all the pellets. And again, you can see the center mass, not as tight as it was before at 20 yards, but still good coverage over the paper for 40 yards, the mid-range choke. I mean, it does a really good job, gives you a nice pattern. So now what I'd like to do is take the mid-range that we just shot and compare it to the long-range choke that we want to shoot at 40 yards. And I want to do a side-by-side comparison with those, just like we did with the 40-yard mid-range and the 20-yard mid-range choke. So here we are at our 40-yard target, and you can see that this is a dense pattern, denser than the mid-range choke was at 40 yards. So this would be a great choke for 40 yards and beyond. Another thing I might mention right now is the patterning that we've done here today, we did off of a bench, and I would suggest taking an offhand shot too to verify your pattern at the same distances you were shooting. So in conclusion, I think that you can see how important patterning is and how important it is to find your point of aim, how your choke and load work together. And unless you pattern your shotgun, you're never going to know what your load and choke are doing together. So I would highly suggest patterning your gun before going hunting or target shooting.